Hey guys, today I wanted to talk about the LV1 system and my 10 favorite plugins. My absolute number one plugin is called InPhase.
Okay, so let's have a look at my favorite 10 plugins from Waves in the LV1. Here's my session, and as you can see, I have two kick drums. It's a dynamic and a condenser. So I inserted the InPhase plugin on my first kick drum channel. You can see it right here, it's inserted. And on the sidechain right here, I have kick condenser inserted. There we go. So we need audio. And those are two kick drums lined up together. So what InPhase will do is sample the transient from both kick drum mics. It's fairly easy. You just need to click on capture right here on the bottom. So I say capture. And as you can see, the audio will freeze for a second, but the signal will still run. And then we can see that it's 0.18 degrees different on both kick drums. We can zoom in right here. So those are my two kick drums. I can make them bigger. And now they are perfectly lined up. Let's see if we hear a difference in bypass. There's quite a big change if you bypass or use the plugin. The sound is way tighter. Let's bypass the plugin and see the difference. You hear the kick drum is way tighter. And I can tell you on a big PA, it will really be tight.
Number two in my preset is Smag Attack.
It's opened right here in the window, and I'm going to show you how it works. So it's inserted on snare top. Let's have a listen. So it's not a gate. It will detect transient again and lowers the level. I have a lot of attack here and a very short sustain. Let's try to change those and see how the sound changed. So that's the same snare drum with more sustain. And with less attack and a lot of sustain, for instance. You can hear all the background noises gone, almost. The reason I'm doing this on snare top, because I also have a snare bottom. Let's have a look at snare bottom. So snare bottom is the opposite from snare top. So here we see snare bottom. It has less attack than snare top because I already have the attack from snare top, and I have more sustain because I only want to hear the snares rattling. So let's have a listen how those two signals line up on snare top and snare bottom. And although I'm using Smeg Attack, you can still hear the ghost notes being played. It can make your drum sound way more tighter and lose all those noise from stage. Now have a listen, kick and snare together with the Smeg Attacks.
On number 3, I have the TG mastering chain on the master. It's my absolute favorite on master.
I inserted it on my master bus. As you can see, there's fairly any EQing going on. There's a little bit of 64 plus 1.5 dB. I took down a little bit of 500, like 1 dB. I took down a little bit of 3K there, like 0.5 dB. And I added some air, 11K, like 1 dB. Of course, it's also a little bit compressing, but let's have a listen how it sounds. Let's go in bypass. Wow, my mix really sounds dull now. Let's plug it in again. A very simple tool. A very simple tool. What everybody should have.
Number 4 in my top 10 is the F6.
And I will explain to you why. I have a vocal here, a very dynamic vocal. And I cut down some S's right here and some low mid-range frequencies, which are a little bit in the way. So let's have a look how that sounds with and without the F6.
Standing alone with the world at my side.
You see those S's disappear?
Reaching for hell, but my hands were tied. Trying to run, I couldn't feel my own feet. My eyes were wide open, but I was asleep. Now I've gone and said my goodbyes. I've laughed and I've learned. I've ached and I've cried.
Let's have a listen again to those vocals at the start of the song, and especially look at the S's.
Standing alone with the world at my side, reaching for help, but my hands were tied. Trying to run, I couldn't feel my own feet. My eyes were wide open.
And number number 5 in my top 10 is the primary source expander, that guy.
This will help me to get a clean vocal signal without any background noise, so I can send it straight to a nice clean reverb. Let's have a look how it works.
Standing alone with the world at my side, reaching for help, but my hands were tied. Trying to run, I couldn't feel my own feet. My eyes were wide open.
And now we're going to solo this vocal with the primary source expander. Let's have a listen.
Standing alone with the world at my side, reaching for help, but my hands were tied. Trying to run.
Let's go and bypass.
I couldn't feel my own feet. My eyes were wide open, but I was asleep. Now I've gone and said my goodbyes. I've laughed and I've learned. I've ached and I've cried. But I won't lie no more. With the sun in my eyes, I'm tired of losing.
This plugin is perfect if you have a lot of backing vocals or a horn section. It will clean up your mix incredibly.
On number 6, I absolutely love Vitamin. Number 6 on my top 10, Vitamin.
Vitamin is very easy to use and it will give some excitement to your mix. Let's have a listen.
Standing alone.
Let's go on
with the world at my side. Reaching for help, but my hands were tied. Trying to run, I couldn't feel my own feet. My eyes were wide open, but I was asleep.
And if you want some more low ends, you just add.
Now I've gone and said my goodbyes. I've laughed and I've learned. I've ached and I've cried. But I won't lie no more. With the sun in my eyes, I'm tired of losing. I'm ready to ride. I won't cry anymore. I've been buried alive.
So Vitamin will add some excitement to your mix.
On number 7, my favorite plugin is the SSL Master Bus Compression.
I usually use it on drums. Let's have a look and a listen. You see, it's barely compressing, but if I bypass it, I will lose character. Amazing how much character I get from this compressor.
On number 8 of my favorite plugins is H-Reverb.
This reverb is an awesome sounding reverb, and I'm going to show you why. Let's have a listen to the mix and the reverb on the vocals.
Standing alone sigh, reaching for help, but my hands were tied. Trying to run, I couldn't feel my own feet.
And now the same vocal without band, just vocal and the H reverb.
Standing alone with the world at my side, reaching for help, but my hands were tied. Trying to run, I couldn't feel my own feet. My eyes were wide open, but I was asleep. Now I've gone and said my goodbyes. I've laughed and I've loved, I've eaten and cried.
The other cool feature in H Reverb is that you have tons of cool presets. And my absolute favorite is if you go to hardware, there are tons of sampled units, like the 780, the M5000 from TC Electronics, the 480 Lexicon, the PCM70, the PCM80, the 224, the SPX990, and tons of units sampled in this library. The H Reverb.
On number 9, my favorite plugins in the top 10 is Abbey Road Plates.
I really love this plugin to be on drums. Let's have a listen to the reverb on drums with Abbey Road Plates. And this is in bypass. Abbey Road Plates. I love it.
Favorite plugin number 10 is Shep's Particles.
It's a very easy use tool with just four knobs. Sub right here, thick, air, and bite. I have an example on the kick drum, and let's have a listen how that sounds. Let's bypass the plugin and see what happens. Now the same plugin, but then on snare top. Shep's Particles, absolutely must have. Thank you all for watching and hope to see you again soon.